This question, we want to have $300,000 for retirement in 35 years. Your account earns 7% interest. So how much do you need to deposit each month? So we're making a monthly deposit. So right away, that's periodic deposits. So we're going to use one of these three right here. So you could ignore the rest. Now this financial formula flowcharts in chapter 7. You can see it in there, and it's labeled and super useful. Okay, so which one do we use? How much would you need to deposit? So this one is how much you need to deposit. So we want to find P0. All right. Find P0. Oh, that's deposit each month, not initially. That's why there's no P0. All right, ignore that. That is a deposit, but that's only when you have an initial deposit and no periodic deposits. What we want to do is deposit each month. I didn't read that part. So that is D, regular to payments, withdrawals or deposits each period. So we want to find D. So right away, we want to use the second formula right here. Let's go ahead and write that one down. Now, I have an extra parenthesis in there in the numerator or denominator. You don't necessarily need it, but I'm going to put it in there because I have it. All right, so PN is the final amount, and that is the 300,000. Let's see, 35 years. So that's N, number of years is 35. K is how often you're depositing, and the interest is compounding. So monthly. K is 12, it says each month, so that's monthly. Rate of interest is 7%. As a decimal, it's 0.07. And that should be all we need here. So we have our 300,000 times 0.07 over 12 divided by 1 plus 0.07 over 12 raised to the NK raised to the 35 times 12. That's times, not a decimal point. Then there's a minus one outside of the exponent. Okay, so we're going to go to our calculator now and type all this in. So we'll start with the 300,000 times parentheses 0.07 divided by 12 close parenthesis. If you want, you can wrap the entire numerator in a parenthesis like this, and then when I hit divided by, that all goes in the numerator. Denominator will do start two parentheses, one plus 0.07 divided by 12. Close the parenthesis. A to the B is raised to the power. You have to start a parenthesis here because you want the 35 times 12 to be done before as a single exponent there. Now the minus one, if you look, that took us down below. So that minus one is not up inside the exponent. It's down below. And we'll do a close parenthesis. And there we see our answer 166 point, I'll round it 166.57. So that's how much we'll deposit each month. So let's uncover that answer. And we see you got the first one. All right, how much interest will you earn? Well, part B, so this is part A. Part B, you want to find your total deposit. And then you want to the amount, the total amount minus your total deposit. So your total deposit, we did that 166. We better use the exact 5, 6, 9, 7. That's probably good enough. Total deposits. So it's this much per month, dollars per month, times 12 months in 1 year, times a lot of years, 35 years. 35 years. All right, so our years cancel, our months cancel, and this product right here will be how much we've deposited total. So I already have that number right there. Let's hit enter. Copy, paste. Sweet. All right. Times 12 times 35 equals all right, so this is our total deposit, and what we want to do is get the difference. We want to get the 300,000 minus that total deposit. That's how much interest we earn, and that will be the number right there. It's the difference between what we put in and the total value. That is all the interest that we would earn.